Good day, and I'm happy to welcome you here on the second, we can say, traditional annual conference that is conducted together with Narodowy Polski Bank, together with the Government of Canada and Kyiv School of Economics. Together with leading economists, scientists from many different countries, we got together here all together to discuss very interesting topics and the role of the central bank in economic development. We discussed this topic a lot, especially now when recovery of economics is very relevant for Ukraine and for many other countries around the world. Last year, our country and the National Bank of Ukraine focused on combating inflation growth. However, the growth was very weak and slow. So inflation is decreasing steadily now. So now the most important issue for us is developing economic growth and who should be responsible for this process. The role of the central bank changed during decades. So the crisis, they always go together with economic development, and that is why most central banks are focused on stability issues. And this is not surprising, because central banks were developed as a special body that should maintain stability, that should take this obligation in front of all the citizens of the country. So national banks, central banks, they should be independent from the government, because they have to work for the long term. People do not like crisis and their effects. However, stability sets its own limits, especially limits for development. And this is the point for discussion in terms of national bank policies. So we have to find the trade-off and the balance in terms of the role of the central bank. The National Bank of Ukraine recently had a short and but very active way to stabilizing economy of Ukraine. There were many different factors that attempt to destroy economy, and that is why our central bank very quickly developed a common vision in terms of central bank policy. So our understanding is that now we have a policy that could be implemented for the long term. It should be proactive, and it, moreover, all the price and financial stability, economic growth, and all other goals should be achieved at the same time and in the most effective way. So how are we going to do this? The most important thing is the money stabilization. In the economical literature, during evaluation of the central bank activities, we usually speak about anchoring our expectations. It means that population believes that the central bank can give stability to the population. So if there is stress among population, if the bank is fulfilling this role, it means that people are satisfied. So people trusted in the currency exchange rate. However, this trust was not fulfilled. The currency devaluated very quickly, and the stability period became shorter and shorter. So of course, the national currency could not enjoy trust, and we had to find new trust anchor that we could give to the population. The anchor that could maintain trust into national currency. So another anchor could be stable and low inflation. And we understood that there is no an alternative for targeting inflation. So inflation is not a problem. When inflation is not a problem, it gives a possibility for planning for long term and attracting foreign direct investments. So those countries that had low inflation, they still were victims of worldwide crisis. So the central bank and enjoyed trust trust of the population, and it helps central banks develop their plans and their policies. So the central bank is accused in raising prices. However, this is not the case. The central bank in the initial stage has to persuade population that it wants to have stable prices, and that is why we need to have stable monetary policy. However, this is a high price for the long-term stability, and there is no any other options. If we do not pay this price, then the economy will always face new and new crises. So moreover, the central bank is able to have this process with less pain. For example, the Central Bank of Ukraine could minimize the prices. So we have inflation decreasing plan, and we have the first results. The central bank had achieved its first goal already in 2016, while keeping the slow but stable growth of economy. So secondly, this policy helps us to have more stable economic growth. Trust and trust anchor helps to decrease exchange volatility and interest rates. The experience of many countries can serve as a proof for this. It is true that stable economic growth does not mean fast economic growth. However, there are no very clear proofs that inflation targeting countries have faster growth. Any monetary policy is not the sole solution. There should be many other solutions that should work together. So the central bank is not the sole driver for the big booms and changes. However, the price stability can be achieved only when there is a healthy financial system existing. So the problem of the financial stability is very relevant for most of the central banks. Speaking about the crisis of 2008, two-thirds of the central banks had the mandate in terms of financial stability, and now this mandate, and now there is four out of fifth banks that enjoy this mandate. So this is a very important aspect of the central bank. On the one hand, the regulation of the central banks should improve economical development. On the other hand, regulation of financial system gives a base for economical growth. So successful results of this work can bring stable and strong economical growth. So based on the estimations of the Banking Committee, so in this situation, the GDP can will grow by 0.6%. However, if the situation is different, the GDP decreases by 0.9%. So Ukraine has a very sad experience of banking crisis. After the right after the recent crisis, we understood that the banking system that exists at the moment decreases and paralyzes economical growth. So the classical banking activity should work together with the schematic bank approach. So the So from the very beginning of the reform that we had, the half of the Ukrainian banks, they left the market. As a result, Ukrainian banking system is more stable and enjoys trust and is more capable of fulfilling its functions. Of course, incapable We removed incapable banks and implemented new approaches in terms of banking regulation based on assessment of banking activities. We implement new tools, and this is not the end. We plan our new policy for the long run. However, we are faced with many other problems in terms of economical growth, and we understand that the wide and open discussion of professionals is very important in order to find solution to burning problems, and that is why you are invited here. You are invited to have this discussion today.